Hey, how you doing there, TSLers? This is Angela the Tip Chick giving you just a glimpse into how we do our meatloaf. Last time, if you paid attention, you saw that we did meatloaf with our sweet pepper saucer. Well, this one we're doing with our urban garden. You see those big chunks right there? That's sweet peppers, that's some tomato. We have our regular sweet urban garden in there. But for you people who are gluten-free and can't use a wheat binder, yes, what you're seeing are my chips in there, which is why you're hearing from me again. So do everything as you usually do, except skip the binder, being oatmeal or flour or whatever you use, and get a bag of our chips, either our original or one of our many other varieties like our smoked paprika or wasabi if you want a little kick to it, our onion and garlic if you like more garlicky, oniony. You make the call, crunch it up as chunky or as fine as you like, as you see. And the tortillas actually will get naturally soft as the meat binds with it. Plus, it takes in the flavor. We also used an 18-year-old balsamic. Oh my God, it's so delicious. So that, and of course, we used a couple of eggs that we just mixed up and dropped them in there. And now I'm just bringing it down to room temperature. And I'll throw it in the oven at 375 for about 45 minutes to an hour, then under the broiler. And voila, you know, you season it to taste. We'll add a little salt, a little pepper, things like that. But the salt from the chips means you don't have to add as much salt. The flavor from the salsa, not too many other seasonings. And the balsamic, it's heavenly. You can actually drink it. I did. All right. Bon appetit. Of that meatloaf. Now this is a pretty nice size cookie sheet. I used a couple pounds of ground beef, which actually was almost 50% off. So a $12 package cost $6. So make sure you shop the sales. Also, it was relatively easy. Once you bring it down to room temperature, it puts off less moisture, so it cooks more evenly. And it also is easier to manipulate and move around. So just think of Play-Doh. That's a little bit more gushy. And I just dropped it out of the bowl, rolled it out, and patted on the sides. And then I squeezed it really tight into a ball again. Not a perfect ball, but more like a loaf of bread. And then put it back and then slimmed it out a little bit more. Okay. Now I'm about to pop it in the oven. 375 for about 45 minutes or 350, 45 minutes. It depends on if you like it rare or not. And just make sure you wash your hands really well. Okay. Okay, this is your last shot. This is Angela, the Chip Chick. Just showing you how the meatloaf turned out. The lighting is a little different because I'm using artificial light as opposed to sunlight. But you still get the idea. You can see just how delicious it is. And what I've done is actually, the juices that were on the side here, actually just poured it over to this pan. Let me see if I can turn the light on so you can see. See that? Just poured it right in there. And I'm about to turn that on high and have it come to a slight boil, and then slowly sprinkle with a regular dinner fork, sprinkle some wheat or white flour in there and get it going until it's lumpy. And then you turn the heat down to a medium high, add water, and you gauge your thickness that way. And you're still stirring as you're cooking the flour and the juices there, and it makes a really nice gravy. Then you turn it down on low, let it simmer a little bit more. Then you can add your seasoning, some salt, some pepper, whatever else you feel you need. But it really shouldn't need much more than a bit of salt, if that. So that's it. That is your salsa tortilla meatloaf made from that salsa lady, where local flavor is so local, es loco. Holla.